British troops at the eastern end of the Normandy line today have uncorked a powerful new drive near Caumont. And to the east, the Americans have not been stopped in their push south. Allied armies are moving into position for an all-out attack on the German Gothic line. The British 8th Army is reported about 7 miles from Corinth, and the Germans have moved 5 rather tired divisions into the region. On Pacific war fronts, American forces have occupied Arrote Peninsula, and we now control more than 2/3 of Tinian Island.
On Europe's eastern front, Soviet troops are moving deeper into Romania. In Italy, the Germans are falling back toward the Gothic line, and Polish troops have driven a strong bridgehead across the Metaura River near the Adriatic. Thank you.
you may listen to this network with assurance that all sources of news will be properly labeled and that we will interrupt programs only with news of exceptional importance and will bring you frequent summaries of all information available.
American tanks and men are swarming across the Brittany Peninsula today, and the cleanup campaign has begun at Brest. Other American columns are turning eastward toward Paris. The Red Army's campaigns against East Prussia and Warsaw are entering the last stage.
Military and essential business travel is now at a new all-time high. Troop movements, furlough and casualty travel, and war production activity must still have first call on our nation's transportation systems. So please don't travel unless it is absolutely necessary. Pleasure travel must wait for victory. Thank you. Have you ever prepared a fresh vegetable plate? And I mean fresh. With vegetables picked months ago and frozen hard as billiard balls? Or eaten meat months old, but as fresh and even more tender than the day it was bought? Purified moist cold will prevent foods from wilting or drying without the use of covered dishes. Sterilamp will utilize ultraviolet rays to kill bacteria, retard the growth of mold, and to eliminate offensive icebox odors. And last, but certainly not least, the space-stealing coils will be gone, doing away with the regular, messy job of defrosting.
Places the Allies in action directly across the strait from the cliffs of Dover. That would mean the invasion is spreading out over a wide area. These are all enemy reports, unconfirmed by our sources, and should be taken with caution.
Sending sets have been parachuted by Allied planes to Europe's underground. Luigi, the Italian farmer, is a member of an underground, and one day, not long ago, this is what happened. Luigi stopped toiling in his vineyard and stood motionless to watch a formation of bombers overhead. He counted them and carefully noted the type of each plane. He wasted no time, but hurried to the shed where he kept his wine barrels. There, from a barrel with a false bottom, he took a small, compact radio sending set. In code, he reported to the Allies through radio, underground, the time, direction, and number of planes in the formation. Then he relaxed. Through radio, underground, Allied interceptors took to the air in time to inflict another defeat upon the enemy. Radio, indispensable to victory, continues to do its important job. Not only in the air, on land, on and under the seven seas, but underground.
Moving fast. Further invasions are coming soon. And right now, the number one priority is no longer airplanes. It's the Navy's vast fleet of landing craft, which will storm the beaches of Fortress Europe and Hirohito's empire in the Pacific. More than 20,000 of them already built and 45,000 more on the way.
Just about 2 hours ago, that the point values of pork and many beef cuts will be sharply reduced starting Sunday. The pork reductions will range from 1 to 3 points, and only spare ribs will remain unchanged. Beef cuts used for roasts, rib steaks, and stews also will be reduced 1 to 2 points. The OPA says on the average, we will get 8% more meat next month. However, point values for veal, lamb, mutton, butter, cheese, lard, and other dairy will be unchanged in March. Reports from nearly every state in the union show that draft quotas are not being met. Senator Johnson and Senator Wheeler disagree with President Roosevelt's recommendation and think the armed forces should lower their standards and take more 4F. But others point out that there are about no substantial manpower to them, that is, on top of the fathers, if the group of 2 million families will stop. The President Roosevelt has ordered all occupational permits reduced.
Elsewhere on the home front, Thomas Clark says that 1 out of every 3 American families now has an income of more than $3,000 a year. That compares with only 1 in 10 families between 1935 and 1940.
And another survey shows that it takes at least $13.23 a week to buy food for a family of 5 in New York City. Well, that's $2.16 more than last year.
Some 16 miles northeast of Nancy.
The Army Airways communication system operates as an individual unit under the Army Air Force's command and is responsible for all airplanes in motion, taking off, landing, getting messages in flight, weather reports, and all ground-to-air and point-to-point communications. To do all this, AACS maintains radio systems in all 48 states of this country and in 52 foreign countries. They divide the entire world into 23 regions of operations. Here is a striking example of the job being done with the Army Airways communication system. Exactly 8 days after American forces had established the first beachhead on one of the New Georgia islands, a complete radio station had been installed and was sending out information vital to our attack in the whole area. Equipment for these stations must be able to take it, must operate perfectly in all temperatures, from the sticky, wet heat of the Solomons to the numbing cold of Greenland.
Dunkirk. The British radio says the Allied invasion line is now sufficiently broad to amount to more than just a beachhead. Of course, we know that additional landings are on the schedule. From the glow of statements from the Germans, these landings are being carried out.
Thank you. Thank you.